To understand at base level, basically, if you see here, so this is our structure. So structure is nothing but a hierarchy, how the system will work. So we have two kind of hierarchy. So one is that organization hierarchy that we have in terms of zonal offices, and then we have area offices. So this is one set of hierarchy, and this structure which I'm speaking about is overall enterprise structure. Okay. So here BG is nothing but the business group. So now what is business group? So business group is nothing but the aggregation of the organization. So let's say now I'm speaking about the Reliance Industries. So Reliance, if you see, they have IT, they have let's say manufacturing, and they also own the retail industry. Okay. So now if I want to speak about, let's say, retail, Reliance Retail. So this is different business by itself. So I will categorize this India business under business group retail India. Okay. So now let's say the operations is there in, let's say, US as well. So I'll depend a separate business group for US or UK, whichever country it may be. Okay. So this is the basic of business group. So basically, you will have multiple entities inside it. So if I want to club, let's say, two, three business. So I'll club into it and I'll say different legal entities. So now what is legal entity? So legal entity is nothing but it is a registration wherein based on the tax compliance, we might have different registration, or we might have the one registration wherein we will use it for different states. So in case of India, let's take this. So we have GST. Under GST regime, we don't need to register in multiple places. So what I will do is that I will register in, let's say, I'm registering in Chennai or Mumbai. So this will become my headquarters, or this will become my legal address. So this legal address, we are calling it as legal entity. Okay. So from this particular office, I'll be submitting my accounts and everything. So that is the reason we call this as a legal entity. Okay. So this is not limited to one. So we don't have any such restriction that we should have only one legal entity. We can have multiple. So this again depends on the requirement of the business. Okay. And then we have the primary ledger. So now what is primary ledger? So let's say we are running a payroll for an organization. Let's take the same example, that is Reliance. Okay. So now if I want to run this payroll, it's not that just I will take a report and I'll just see the what you call the benefits and the deduction. So always I should link with specific accounts. So where this accounts will fall, this will fall into GL module. So this is what we call as a primary ledger. Okay. Yeah. So then we have something called operating unit and inventory. So this is not specific to us. So this is just for an understanding. So operating unit is nothing but the unit which generates the expense or it generates the revenue. Okay. And inventory unit, we know very well that it stores some sort of items. Okay. So now we have something called legal employer. So legal employer is the actual employer or the unit which handles the payroll and the employee maintenance, and everything will be handled under this particular unit. So this is not necessary that we need to have only legal entity as a legal employer. This is an option, but we should have an HRMS organization. If at all I wanted to maintain my employees and I wanted to track all those expenses that I'm giving to my employee, and if I want to run the payroll for this particular month or any given month, so I should have my HRMS organization. Okay, so this would be our high level structure. And also we have some sort of security wherein we will have restrictive access. So it is not that all the users will have access to all the organizations. So this is kind of restrictive based on the business policy. Okay. So this is our enterprise structure. Any doubt in this?
Hello, sir.
Yeah, yes, Madhav.
Sir, this is Madhavan, sir. Just now
Yeah.
I joined.
Yeah, yes, please.
Sir, I have completed my mechanical engineering.
Okay.
Can you explain me what is an entity?
Okay, so entity is nothing but an organization. So here what we mean by legal entity is nothing but, so we have a company called Reliance, let's say Reliance Retail Industries. Okay, so now this is an individual entity which we are saying as a company. Okay, so this company has registration in a place called Mumbai. Okay, so this registered address we are calling it as legal entity. So entity is nothing but an organization, basically.
Name of an organization.
Yeah, correct, correct, exactly.
Then what's in primary ledger?
Yeah, primary ledger is related to finance, but we need to understand the basics. Why we need this primary ledger? Because when you run this payroll and the other activities, basically what will happen is that it will pick the accounts from the GL. So GL is, even though it is related to finance, we will need to understand few things because we will be running the payroll for the entire company. So at the end of the day, our payroll record and our GL record should match. So whatever the transactions or whatever the payroll that we are running for the particular month, this will be transferred to our primary ledger, which means this is nothing but an accounting book. So it will have...
Primary ledger calculates the salaries, simply the accounts of the workers.
No, this will not calculate the salaries. This will have the balances of the particular month. So, if I want to understand, let's say...
Profit, for example.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, you can say.
Yeah, so now let's say I want to understand, let's say I have a count of 500 employees. So, I have run for all the employees, okay? So now, if I want to understand that for a particular employee, how much I have deducted or how much I have given as a part of a benefit. Okay. So this I cannot do it through my primary ledger. So what I can achieve from my primary ledger is that how much I have made or how much I have dispensed through this particular account. So we will have an account code combination. So this balance level information I can pick from the primary ledger. But if I want to understand the details of it, that is my deductions and my earnings, all those details will be available only in my payroll module.
Primary. Okay.
Yeah.
So what's the operating unit?
Yeah, operating unit, this is not related to us, but just for an understanding I told. So operating unit is nothing but the unit which makes the expense or revenue. So let's take the same example as Reliance. So Reliance, if you see the retail shops, we will have one in, let's say, Keenagar, one in, let's say, Nandanam. So in this case, both the units are generating revenue. Okay. So both the units are the branch office. We will consider this as an operating unit. Okay. And also, I have an headquarters which will generate the expenses. Basically, I have a process wherein the head office will make the expenses, the employees' expenses, the local conveyance. So everything will be made by my head office. So in this case, since this is making some expenses, even my headquarters will be considered as an operating unit. Yeah, so then inventory unit, it's nothing but to store the items, that's what.
Then basically I have a common doubt.
Yeah.
What's the basic function of an HRMS? What we have to do? Can you explain me in a song?
Yeah, HRMS, basically you have multiple actions or the functions. So I will use HRMS to maintain my employee records. Probably I can retire an employee, or I can give promotion to the employee, or I can, if I want to do the performance analysis of the employee, I can do it, or if I want to run the payroll, I can do it. So there are multiple, similarly, we have multiple options and this thing inside it. If you break down into pieces, you will have multiple options, like we have job hierarchy, then we have employee hierarchy. Then we have approval mechanism, and we have leaves and the other approval or flows. All those things are part of HRM.
For each and every individual, there will be a particular account. Will there be for each and every individual of an organization, there will be a particular. We have to maintain the individual's record.
Yeah, this record will be maintained using employee number. So let's say I add, so there is a setup wherein we can set up this sequence. So if I join into this company, I will have set up sequence. So every company might have their own sequence, but I will be identified using this employee number called, let's say, 001. So with this, I will be identified. So this will become my unique record wherein I can just go to the query form and I can search my records.
From the performance to the number of days he is absent, what function he is doing, remarks on the employee, all are maintained with this single
challenge. Yeah, all are maintained. So this we can see it in the payslip report. So payslip report is something that after running the payroll. So which will calculate all those leaves and this thing. So we have formula and the other options inside.
That also has the PF production, ESA. Will also be included in payroll, no?
Yeah, PF and ESI will be included, but this is part of compliance. So this is specific to each country. So if you take, let's say, Middle East and the Oman and the Kuwait countries, so wherein we don't have, much compliance. And the taxation and these things are very less. But if you take India kind of cases, we have PF, ESI, and tax deduction. All those
companies. So considering taxation in Middle East, the taxation may vary. For example, in India, we use GST, as a single correct. Point tax.
Correct.
But in the Middle East countries, the taxation may vary, no? So you have to understand the taxation, no? Basically.
Yeah, taxation basically, if you see, so this is one kind of element. So we will see it in the future class, but for now, understand this, we have element. So element is nothing but each component. So here I have basic pay, I have travel allowance, I have conveyance. Similarly, so these are like elements, we call it in HRMS or the payroll module. So similarly, we have a tax component also inside it, or the tax element. So we should give a formula wherein how tax should be generated. So we should write a formula in this. So let's say I have a requirement wherein in UAE or Kuwait, it is 5%. So I will define this element in a way that this will generate the 5% tax on month basis. So if I'm into India business, I'll write the formula in a way that it will generate, let's say 15, 20, or if I want to write a condition, whether based on the condition and the rules, let's say if the salary is above 5 lakh, it should generate, let's say 10%. If it is above 10 lakh, it should generate 20%. So I can give a condition and I can derive all those values and I can calculate the taxations. So this is part of element definition.
This comes under particular finance. You know? In case of employee appraisal, another model may be used. Is it correct?
Yeah, correct. We have something called performance appraisal and the other.
Performance appraisal. And also sometimes if an employee gets an MO, it must memo in case of any memo, if you are also gets, it will also be included in another specific module. Is it correct?
Memo in the sense, what are you referring exactly?
Memo in the sense, for example, if someone's performance is bad, his attendance is also not so good. So it will be added in some remarks. So there will be a separate module for that.
Yeah, that we can have it. I mean, for that we don't need a separate module. So inside the employee maintenance itself, we can add those remarks. Okay. And also if, let's say I wanted to retire this particular employee due to any other reason. So that also can be done inside HRMS. So for this, we don't need to go for a different module. We can do it in the HRMS itself. So we can retire at any point of time. Yeah, anything else?
I think so. Next, you can move on.
Okay, I'll move to the application. Okay, so my screen is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. So what we will do is that, so basically to explain, so this is our human resource responsibility. So before that, I'll take a minute to explain. Okay, my session got expired. Give me a minute. Okay, so before getting into human resource details, so I'll explain a few things here. So this is our system admin responsibility. So what does this particular responsibility does is that it will maintain our users and responsibility maintenance. So if you see here, so we have something called security. So under security, I have two options. So one is user and the another one is responsibility. So now what is responsibility? So if I want to create any new employee, I will need this responsibility called human resource. Okay. So unless I have this in place, I'll not be able to create it. So how I'm creating this employee is that through this responsibility, and how I'm able to see those functions which allow me to create a new employee is that using this option called menu. So this menu will have set of functions and the other features. So wherein I'll be able to enter all those employee details, process, payroll, and add element, cost element, everything, okay? So this is our base. So now we cannot directly attach this menu to our user. So we will have to create the kind of a middleware wherein menu will be attached to the responsibility. And this responsibility will be attached to our user. Okay. Yeah. So that's about the responsibility. And we have also few options, like if I want to exclude any feature. Let's say I don't want all users to access this, which means I have also the setup. Yeah. Yes.
So before my net is disconnected, sir.
Okay. Till when you were there? Sorry, I did not notice that. Maybe if you can tell me when you were dropped off, so I can start from there. Or you have this recorded session also, probably you can see that as well.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, is that fine?
Okay, sir. You can tell me this one, this structure again, sir.
Yeah, sure. This one, right? And the responsibility part. Okay. So what is responsibility is that, so this is needed if I want to create any employee or if I want to run any payroll process or anything that I wanted to do, I will need this responsibility. So how I'm getting this options like create employee, update employee, all those options are being given using this menu. So this menu will have multiple options inside it. So let's take this, let's copy this menu. And if I go out, so I have application under this, I have menu. Okay. Okay, so now if you see, so these are the functions that we have for this particular menu. So if I create any new responsibility and if I attach this menu, so these are the options that I will have. So I will have options to enter and maintain my employee and the workforce separation and the all those things. So separation is nothing but a retire employee process and the other things. So similarly, for each menu, we will have set of functions and menus. So the collection of submenus, we call it as menus. And we are attaching this menu to the responsibility and that
responsibility. Yeah, I got a doubt, sir.
Yeah, yes.
So for example, if each and every employee has a particular responsibility, for example, if there's consider an assistant engineer,
Okay.
His work where is with CEO, he has a top level management.
Okay.
You have to maintain the records of a CEO, the responsibility for him varies. You have to have the entire department, you have to have access. So you give different menu concept. In case of an assistant engineer, only few responsibility he has to do. So you have to give only few menu options. Is it correct, sir?
No, there are two things to it. So one thing you are asking about the access level, and the other thing is about the what are the options that he will see. So what we are seeing it here in the menu is that options he will see. Whether he will be able to see, create employee record or update employee record or delete employee record. So these are the options that will be provided using menus. And the other option which you are saying, he has four departments. So now I want to give access only for two departments. So how I will do is I have something called security rule. So using security rule, I will restrict this particular person in order not to create or not to allow access to this particular unit. So that way I can restrict. So there are two different things. So what we are seeing now is that only for the functionality checks, whatever the options that I can access. Okay.
So these are the 10 options we have access, sir.
Yes, correct.
Depending on the employee, these functions, we can modify.
Yeah, yes, very well we can modify. So we can simply say, we will want to copy the submenus because we will not know. If you see here,
so
we only have the codes. So we will not understand it basically. So we will have to go to tree. And under tree, if you click this, it will tell us what it is. So let's take one record. So let me open this. And now if you see here, so it will tell me it is workforce separation.
What workforce separation?
Workforce separation is nothing but our retirement and relieving employee from the company. So that is what we call as an workforce separation. So workforce is nothing but a specific employee. So that, this is the term that they'll be using here. So it is nothing but workforce separation. Okay. So similarly, we will have to take all those things. So let's say I wanted to give only this option. So this particular user will be accessing only or will be doing only the separation process. So what I will do is that I'll take this one, I'll copy this submenu, and from here I'll say create new. So this create new will allow me to create a new menu. So after creating this new menu, what I will do is that I'll create a new responsibility and attach this menu to there. Okay. So this this way I can restrict the user access or how he can see the things. Okay. Any other doubt?
Sir, can you work on, for example, can you create a particular model for an employee? Can you create and show in this school? I will be able to.
Create an employee in the sense you are asking, how to create an employee?
Can you create an employee now? That's a new recruitment. And the employee has joined the organization. How will you create a new one?
Yeah, okay. I'll show, but it will be like we are jumping.
Okay, sir.
I'll just show this option. After this, I'll go back to the system administration and probably. Okay. So if you see here, so this is our employee maintenance. We'll see this as an people. Okay, so people is nothing but employee. So now if I want to query any particular employee, I'll just say the full name, or if I want to give the employee number, I can give it. As I said, this is our unique identifier. Okay, and country like US, they have social security, and few other European countries as well, so they have it. So if at all we have those information, we can track it using the social security also. So even this becomes our unique way of tracking the employee. Okay. And then here, if you see, we have three things totally. So one is applicant, contingent worker, and employee. So employee is
not,
So employee is nothing but your full-time employee, wherein he will work, let's say 8 hours or any given time limit. Okay. And other option is that contingent worker. So contingent worker is something like a contract worker. So they will hire for a certain period, let's say 6 months. And once the contract period is done, so they'll be moved out of the company. Okay.
Yeah.
And the third option is that applicant. So applicant is nothing but I'm applying for this company. So I will register this applicant and I will store all the track record and the basic information in the system. After that, I'll convert this applicant into my employee. So either it could be probably the contingent worker or employee, but as an initial stage, I'll create this this person as an applicant. So that is the difference between each one of it. Okay. So now let me take any one employee. Okay, so this is how it will look like. So we have more options inside it. So the basic information is that first name, last name, and the title we can give it. And whatever you are seeing in yellow, it is mandatory. And whatever you are seeing it in white, it is optional. Okay. And yeah, so we have different options like preferred, suffix, and all those things. And then we have the gender and the actions. Okay. All those information. So I can just create a hire, or probably I can create an applicant. Okay, and then I'll mark this particular person as an employee. So once I mark this person as an employee, so the employee number will be generated. So we can see it is 24. Okay, and social security is optional. As I said, it will be applicable only for a few countries. So this will be always optional. And after that, we have few personal information, date of birth, and the status, nationality, age, and the other details. So age will be calculated based on our date of birth. Okay. And then we have few options, like if I want to add picture and address, I can add those details. Okay. And then I have employment details. So if at all this particular applicant is hired, I'll have the employment details. So these are like basic information. So if I want to calculate, capture the visa and the other process also, so I'll be able to capture it. We have an option called DFF. So to store the additional information. Okay.
So in a simple way, it means you can view the complete details of the employee.
Yes, correct. Option. Correct.
And the permanent medical other benefits.
Yeah. So this is where I'll say that this particular employee is working under this particular unit. So if you see here, so this person is working for Vision Project Manufacturing USD. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So this is his company or the organization that he's working for. And his role is that buyer, the procurement agent.
Purchase officer.
Yeah, purchase officer, basically. So that defines the job and position. And then payroll. So payroll is nothing but our entity by which we will be paying out the monthly salary.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we will give the location. And apart from that, we also have few additional information like the statutory information, supervisor, and if I'm in proportional or the notice period, so I can give those details as well. Okay. So I have given Vision Services as an
statutory. So probation and notice period, it means once the employee puts paper, then only it's updated.
No, it's not that after you resign from your company, notice period is given.
Before,
notice period is the term that is defined before you join the company. So when you are joining this new company, you will be given terms and conditions. So that is part of your joining process. So wherein you will have notice period, probation, all those things. So when you are relieving from this company, so that is when this notice period will start. Okay.
For few companies, there will be a 1 month notice period.
Yes.
For few others, there will be a 3 month notice period.
Yeah, correct.
Once the employee wants to get moved to another organization, he announces that I am in notice period. Then only this on gets updated. Is it correct?
No, it will get updated even earlier to that. So how it will happen is that. So if at all I don't have any record that this particular person will have, let's say, 3 months of notice period. So system will not understand that whether I want to relieve this particular person immediately or I will take 1 month to relieve this particular person or let's say probation. So probation is nothing but the period, kind of a training period. So those details I need to input to the system so that system will understand and it will relieve this particular person when he puts the paper or give the resignation request. Okay, so basically we need to give all those inputs to the system. Okay. Yeah, apart from that, we have other information as well. So there are a lot of information. So probably you will see when we come to this page.
Another doubt, sir.
Yeah.
If we have to input all these details, we must know the all this data must be provided. The customer will provide all these data, no?
Yeah, the employees will be giving it. I mean, business will give all those details. So here it
is. You can access the.
Yeah, it's not that business will give all those details. Because if you see whatever is in LO, this is mandatory. For sure, you should collect these details. But other than that, if we have, let's say, if a customer wants to have the supervisor and the other details, we can set up the supervisor. But let's say customer don't want to give the statutory information like yearly or the what do you call the probation period information, all those things. So it's a business requirement whether they want to capture in the system or they wanted to have it in the off system. So that depends. But these details we will have to get it from the customer, which are marked in yellow. Okay. Yeah, so that's what we will see in detail when we come to employee maintenance and the other task. So for now, I'll go back to the system administration and let's complete that part and we'll come back to HRMS. Fine. Okay, so we saw this. So menus and these options. So now we are done with responsibility. So let's say that I have created my responsibility. So what I will do next is that I have reports. So if you see here, so reports is nothing but let's say if I want to run any program or the report, I can run it from here. So this is module specific. If you see here, I will not have anything specific to HRMS. Or payroll. So this is completely system maintenance and the other details. Like if you see the purge ATP and other things. So this is to maintain the system. So this is entirely different. So when I log in into the HRMS application, by then I will see these details. That is relevant to HRMS or the payroll. Okay. So similarly, if I want to see those reports, what I have to do is that I have to go here, request, and create a request set wherein I will attach all the given reports. Okay. So here you can see that we can attach the program or we can attach the application or we can attach the program set. So we will create a program and then we will create what do you call the 4 or 5 programs we will combine and say it is in set. So similarly, we will create this and after creating this, what we will do is that we will attach in the responsibility. Okay, so once this is done, so This is where we will basically create a user. Sorry, this.
First we'll get the responsibility, then we'll go with the reports.
Yeah. We don't have sequence there, so we can create the reports first, and then probably we can create the responsibility. So once this responsibility is created, we can define the user. Okay. So now.
First we create the reports, and then we can move to responsibility.
Yes, correct.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So now we have the user creation. So this is the page where we will give access to any specific user. So this is either to give access to the user, or it is to revoke the access that is given on earlier. Okay. So what I will do is that I will give a username. Okay. So now I will not be able to give the username, because for this particular user login, so creating a new user is restrictive. So I'm not giving at this point. I'm just explaining how it should be given. Okay. So after we give username, we will have to give the password. Okay. And then we should give the effective date. So now let's say I don't want this user to be active. I'll give the due date as today. Basically, I'll end it this. So that this user will not be able to access this login. Okay. And here I will attach the responsibility that I created in the earliest step.
Yeah, any effective date, I don't doubt, sir.
Yeah.
For example, if I want the user to access the, consider 8th June. Okay. Then I will until from 2 date I will update 8th June 2021. So you can access the file. Access till 8. After 8, you cannot access the data. Is it correct, sir?
Correct, correct. Mm. Okay, so similarly here. Okay, yeah. Mm. So this is for the user, and here we are seeing for responsibility. So here also, if you see, we have effective date from and to. So this is for user, and this is for responsibility. So the difference is that, let's say for human resource, I have 5 different responsibility that has been assigned to me. So now I don't want this particular employee to have 5 different responsibilities. So I wanted to give only 2 responsibilities to him. So what I will do is that I'll end this option. So here in this process, he'll be able to log in, and he'll be able to see the 2 responsibility. But only this 3 end-dated responsibilities, he will not be able to see. But if I end it for the user, he will not be even logging into the system. It will say invalid password. Okay. Yeah. Any doubt till now?
No, sir.
Okay. So we'll move to HRMS.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, so we will start.
Sir, after class, can you give me notes or anything else, sir?
Yeah, I can arrange for that. I mean, we don't have it, but I can arrange for you. No, no issue. I'll give it to you. I'll upload in the drive. You can download from there.
That's a better, sir.
Yeah. Okay, we'll start.
Yes.
Okay. So we will start with defining organization. Okay. So that is from business group we will start. So before creating the organization, we will create few locations, because we will have to attach this location to our organization. Okay. So let me say Reliance Business Group. Okay. Okay, so I have just given the mandatory information. So that is in yellow. Okay, so I have filled in with my address. So next thing that we have is related to supply chain part, that is to give the shipping information. So ship to details, we don't know about it. So we have given the basic information to create the business group. Okay, so I'm just saving this and I'm creating two more address. So I created three address. Probably we can manage with this. Okay.
Sir,
so,
once you have
said, yeah.
Sir, on,
yeah.
Sir, once I created any details, sir. If there is any fault, wrong data, but the data is stored, can we modify it?
Yeah, certain data we can modify, but also we have certain data wherein we will be. One moment. Yeah, certain data we will not be able to modify it. So let me let me query this and show. Okay, so here if you see, if I want to change the address, I'll be able to change it, but if I want to change the country, if you see here, so this is frozen. I'll not be able to change. And the name of the business group, if I want to change, I can change it, but provided no transactions were created in the system. Because after creating the transaction, if you change anything, so let's say I have implemented HRMS for a client called Reliance, and after 1 month I realized that instead of saying Reliance, I had typed something else. So now, which means the name that they have registered is different from what we have entered. So now if I want to change after running 1 month payroll, this will affect my entire system, because last month I have given the payslip and the other details were generated, and it has reflected my database also. So now if I change it, definitely it will have some impact. So always we should make sure before making the transaction, the data, the details, whatever we have entered, it is correct and fine. Okay, so that is why we have different instances. So instance is nothing but application. So what we are seeing is one application. So basically, if you go into implementation or any support project, so you will see different applications are the instance. So one will be there for the testing, and one will be there for development, and one will be our production environment. Okay.
So another.
Yeah.
Sir, if in Chennai you have Reliance business group in Chennai, you have updated. Similarly, there will be a group in Mumbai. So there will be another set of application for a different. In same name, you have two. That's the doubt.
No, you are asking for this one. Like, let's say.
In Chennai, it's okay.
Hmm.
And Mumbai also, there will be a Reliance business group. For that, there will be a separate set of activities.
No. For India, it will be one Reliance. Because if you see, Reliance founder, Ambani, so he will be managing from Mumbai office. So it is not that he will register in let's say Delhi and he will register in Gurgaon. So it is not going to happen. So it will be only on Mumbai office will be going to operate the entire application. Okay. So always it will be country specific, the business group. So we will not create different business group by each state. So state
kind
of breakdown. So how we will manage this state is that we can manage through our registration, that is legal entity. Okay. So which we can manage.
Different countries also.
Yeah, if it is different country, for that case we can create different business group. Okay.
Because in the US there will be different states.
No, different state is different from different country. Because
if
because if you see inside India, I will not have different tax rate or anything with respect to my registration and the tax compliance. But whereas if you speak about different countries or the transaction between different, let's say Reliance is in
Los Angeles, there is Los Angeles and New York, we can consider.
Yeah, no, that will be entirely different, because there if you see the tax rate between one state to other state is different. So in New York it is 10%, probably Los Angeles it will be 8% or 5%. So
since India is a GST single point tax, you are applying the single.
Yes, correct.
Depending on the tax only we can create it. So you have to have a base process before applying the all the details.
Yes.
Is it correct, sir?
Correct. Okay. So that's what it's based on this thing. Compliance. So based on the compliance, we will suggest business that how to configure the structure. Because they will not know, probably if they have used SAP or any ERP joint application. So they might know about the organization structure and how it is maintained, all those things. But most of the cases, we will not see those kind of things. So we will have to suggest how they can frame their organization structure.
In inquiry stage itself, they will suggest.
Yes.
All these details.
Yes.
In inquiry stage itself, we can suggest these are applicable. The entire queries will be solved in the inquiry stage itself.
Yes. So we will start with the requirement gathering and we will start understanding their system. So we will sit for the solution that we call CRP sessions. So there itself, we will advise them how to take about the organization structure. Okay. So we are good with this? Okay, fine. So I'll start with defining the organization. So let me create an business group. I'll say REL business group. Okay, so this is where we are defining whether this is a business group or this is an HR organization or what exactly is that. So unless we give these details here, system will not understand what organization that.
So if it's manufacturing unit, you will give a manufacturing unit.
Yeah.
So if it's a service sector, telecommunication will cover it as telecommunication.
Yes, correct. If it is asset organization or auditable unit, or let's say this is an budget organization, or let's say this is an, what do you call, an unit which handles the IT. So we can define that as well. So anything that we can define, if you see here, so we have a list of things. Okay. So we can define anything in this. Okay, so we have given this. So the next step is to give the basic information to the system. So these are the information that we can input to the system. So there will be a lot of details that we can capture. So based on the requirement, we can input. So the mandatory one is this one. So what you are seeing in asterisk is the mandatory option. So I'll just click business group info. So wherein we will have to tell the system that how to create or generate the employee number and the short code for it, everything. So I'll say automatic for the employee generation and also for the applicant this thing. Okay, and these are the details that will be defaulted, so we will not have to create it again. So I'll just give the same information. So these details we can change it, so provided no transactions was created in the system. Okay, so these are the mandatory information that I have given, and fiscal year if I want to give, I can give. So this is nothing but the basic information when the business started.
Flex field means, what it means a flex field?
So flex field is nothing but it will allow us to store any kind of information. So now let's say I want to add a new job. So I cannot just enter the details. So the reason why we have flex field is that I want to protect my data, or I don't want any mislead or data entry in the system. So for that reason, what I will do is that I have something called segment. So after this, we will see those things. So before that, I'm just giving a glimpse on it. So what is flex field basically? So here we have a segment and we have the values. So segment is nothing but a structure how this job role should be used. So in a way, let's say I want three different clients to be captured under job. So I can create a three different segment. If I want to if I want to capture three different items, I can capture three different items. So here I'll add the values there in the flex field segment, so that whatever values are there in the system, I will use it. So say I have an system wherein I'm giving an entry for a CFO. So the CFO I can enter as chief financial officer, and the other person, the other person who is working under payroll, might enter this as an CF officer. So it might be, so basically I don't have control in my data entry. So in order to make this control, I will set up the segment and I will add the values. So the values that I'm adding is after approval. So I'll get the proper approval from the management and I will put the entry in the system. So this is the actual way we values. So this will have more security. Okay. So
for example, if I given flex field of CFO, I am giving a code of A0. That a particular A0 will be followed for the entire. Yes. Correct, sir.
Yes, correct. Correct. Whatever I
enter. CFO, because in
So
because in different areas of the country, the position varies. In India, it will be CFO. In US, it will be another CFO officer. So I am creating a common segment that is AO. Considers AO. So for the entire process, the AO means it's a particular role. Is it correct, sir?
Yes, correct. So we will create a common value inside this segment value, and we will use it across the business. Let's say I have something in US. So I will use the same AO. And if I have business in India, I will use the same AO. So same sequence will be followed for the
other. For that purpose, flexibility is used.
Yes, correct.
Wow. So another word in the flex field, can you go to great flex field once again?
Yeah.
Once we can, there is also sir. What is there? There are many possibilities. There is APR great at this.
So this is test environment. So we will have basically we don't have any restriction that we wanted to have only one great flux field or two great flux field in test environment. Since this is a test, we will have any list. If you see here, so we have the counter is more, but in production or in the real time, if you see, it is only one, that is great flux. So if I don't to have this great flux field and I want to have my custom flux field, I can create a new one, but it will not be more than two. I'll create a new one, and the seeded one which is given by Oracle is great flux field. So if I don't want to use that, I'll be going to create a new one, so but not more than two. Since this is personal, having more number of great flux fields. Okay, anything else?
Nothing.
Okay, fine. So that's about it. And so as I said, these are like optional information. The physical year and the minimum working age and this thing. So this is not mandatory. So I'm just leaving it. Okay, so now we are done with business group creation. Okay, so
this was saving, save options.
Save option, you can click this one, yellow button, or you can just say control plus yes.
I see.
Okay. And if you want to query this particular business group, what you will do is that you will press F11. So this field will be frozen. And now you will type the value. So this is my business. So the reason why I'm using percentage is that I don't know the exact name of it. So I know that it will start from REL. So I'll just say percentage. Okay. So here you can see that this is different. The reason being is that we gave percentage. So whatever the combination the system can pick, system will pick. So now if I press down arrow, I'll get my business group. That is REL underscore business group.
Okay, sir. Got it.
Okay. Yeah, so that's about it. So we will create also the business group. HRM org. So here if you see, so we have a few human resource or related information. So that is if I want to give the costing information. So these details we will give it once we complete our payroll configuration. So this will be our basic level wherein we created just the business group and the HRMS organization. So these additional information we will see it at later point of time. Okay, so now what I will do is that I'll mark also this particular payroll unit as employer as well. So what is employer is nothing but this is the actual unit that will be used for my actual payroll process and the other things. So this will mark this as an legal employer of my employee. Okay. Yeah. So we are done with creating the organization. Okay. So next step, what we will do is that we will create the. Yeah. So we have a hierarchy. So probably we will. Okay. First we will create the job and then we will come to the hierarchy. Okay, so here we have a job group. So I'll select the job group from here. So I'll have to create this group separately. And after that, what I will do is that I will create the job code here. Okay, so before this, I'll get to this flex field and probably I'll show how it is designed. And I'll also tell you like how we can design it. It's more flexible actually. Okay, so first I will take the segment. So inside segment, if you see, if I type human resource, I will have all those flex field. So now the flex field that we are seeing is that job flex field. So I'll click this. So here you can see that there are a lot of flex field. So to take the flex field that we attach to our the business group is that using this option. So I'll just say a query. So this blue touches our query page. So I'll just say job flex field. Okay. So here we are seeing few options. That is allow dynamic insert and then enabled we know. And then we have freeze flex field definition. So freeze flex field definition is basically used to avoid the addition to this particular flex field. So let's say I have defined this flex field for two segment. So now let's say this user has this access to create or enter anything, but let's say he by mistake he is trying to add something. So I'll not be able to add anything. Why? Because I have enabled this option that freeze flex field definition. So if I unfreeze this, I'll be able to add it. So I'm just unfreezing this. So now if you see, I'll be able to add it or edit it. So editing is not suggestible, but still system will allow me to do so. Okay. And then if you see here, so we have a segment separator. So segment separator is nothing but how do we want to separate it? Whether we want to separate by the dot or comma, whatever thing that we want to separate. So separator is nothing but let's say for job code, we have given us 100 and for job name, we have given us, let's say accountant. So when we select this as a dot, it will say 100 dot accountant. Okay. So which means it is separated. That's it. So these are the options that we have for the separator. Okay. And then we have, these two options are related to finance, that is to cross-validate segment and the other thing. Yeah, so this is our segment that we have defined. So it's not just limited to two. So since this is seeded flex field that is given by Oracle, so we have these two segments. But we can create till 30 segments. So based on the requirement, we can capture the details. So here, if you see, I have given just two segments, that is simple two segments, that is job code and job name. Okay. Yeah, so I'm done with this. So let me freeze this particular flex field. And once it is freezed, we will have to click compile. So compile is nothing but it will check. Okay, there is a restriction to update it. Okay, fine. So why we will run this compile is that it will check whether there is any issue. Let's say there is a mandatory field that has to be entered, but I did not give those details. So if you see here, so this value set is mandatory. So if I have not given this value set, then system will say that value set is not there, or it will say any sort of error, it will display. So we will check that and we will correct it. So basically it's just to make sure that whatever information that we are punching in, this is correct and system can take this record. Okay. Yeah, so that's about the segment. So once the segment is defined, we will have to add values to the segment.
This is a list of global fixed fields created already.
Already in the sense we have these things, right? So these are seeded by Oracle, but whatever we are seeing in underscore, like if you see here YT underscore.
It's URG underscore of job dot kf of this. That means it's a separate organization.
Yeah, separate organization. So for testing purpose, someone has created in this name. Okay. Yeah, so let me open any sample thing. Okay. So now under this job, if I want to add, let's say I don't have a job called senior accountant. So I have a generic classification that is accountant or analyst or anything. So now if I want to add any new value, I'll click this and I will say control down arrow. So this will allow me to create a new record. Okay, so unless I create the record here, I'll not be able to select or enter any details in the job flex field or the job definition that we were doing in the earlier step. Okay. So that's about the flex field. So this flex field thing, whatever we are seeing here, so this will apply for all those things. So all the flex field that we attached to our business group. Okay. So now we have created this thing, the structure. So what we will do is that we will create a job. Okay, so here we can see this is okay. So if you see here, I don't see any list of value, but let's say I just type something randomly, so it is not going to allow me to enter it. Okay, I think the flex field, they have given a free field. That's why it's allowed. Okay, so let me give some numerical value to it. Okay, so dates, we should make sure that this is on the correct date, because unless it is in the correct date, we will not be able to register it. Because if you give one date here in the job and the other date in employee creation, system will not accept it. So that's the reason we can give this, or we can use this option called effective date. So if we give effective date, okay, let me clear this and let me show. Okay, so now if you see here, we could see date as 1st June. So now I'll change here as 1 January. Okay, I'll just say one. So this will be a change. So I don't need to be cautioned every time. So I'll just give the job name. So I have given job code and this is accountant.
Accountant and job code is 01.
Yes, correct. Okay, so we have created this particular job. So now if I want to add any additional information, so I have something called BFF. So here I can capture all those details. So this is a standard BFF for the additional information that is available. So if I want to customize it, I'll be able to customize it. Okay. Yeah, so we are done with job creation. So next what we will do is that we will create position. So here we can see this is 1st January 2021. So I'll just say okay. And I'll say 01 and it's accountant. Okay, then we have position type. So how do we want to have it? So whether we wanted to have this as an single use, or we wanted to have this as an shared role, or we wanted to have this as an pooled one. This is nothing but consolidated role. We will make it as a single position. So for now, I don't want to give all this shared and this option. So I will just say say none. Okay, and this is a permanent position. So I'll just mark permanent. And I'll mark the organization that we created. So that is right. Yeah. So here hiring status, we have two things. So one is active and the other one is proposal. So proposal is nothing but it is not in approved state, which means we are creating this new position. So let's say we have a role called CTDO, Chief Technology and Development Officer. So this has been combined now, but earlier, let's say we have it in two different roles or the position, that is Chief Technology Officer and Chief Development Officer. So now we wanted to club this both the positions. So this will be in proposal state till it is getting approved. Okay. So for those cases, I will say this is in the status of approval. But now this is a generic role, that is accountant. So that I have got from business. So I will say the position is active. Okay. And the location system will take based on the inventory, I mean, not inventory, HRMS organization that we have given here. Okay. And apart from that, we can give the additional information as well, that is work timings and to whom he's reporting and all those information. Basically, it is nothing but our hierarchy. So we haven't defined that method, so I'll just say save and I'll close this. Okay. Yeah. So next option is let's say create a new employee. Okay. For this, let me see.
He's the accountant for accountant.
Yeah. Yes, correct.
First, we created the organization name, then we set the flexible data. Then we create a flexible data means for a particular person, we are creating a code. For example, the RK is an accountant, so for a person, we are creating the code as 01 accountant. Then we are correct. Setting its name. Is it correct, sir?
Correct, correct.
So for every particular person, we have to follow the entire from the basic, we have to follow. Is it?
No, basic in the sense you are asking from organization creation.
No, or organization we have created it to say, okay, for accountant we are creating this. Then we are coming for junior accountant. For junior accountant, set the data, flexible data is 02, any other code. Yes. Then we have to enter yes. the data. Is it correct, sir?
Yes, correct. Same process.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, so I have given the last name. And yeah. I have given the gender and then action. Action is nothing but create employment. Okay. And the moment I have given this, it will pop up with a few details. So I have selected employee. Okay. So now I have given I'll give the data. So let's say. Okay. So the next option, what I will do is that I'll click assignment. Okay.
Zero.
So under
slash no.
No, it is 01 dot accountant. Because if you remember, the flex field what we gave is that dot. Dot is our separator.
Oh,
okay, so others are like optional things. So payroll, we will come to this once we create this. Okay, so now now that we have assigned organization and we said that this is an accountant. So based on this assignment number has been generated. That is 4106. Okay, and assignment number is nothing but it is just to track our this thing, what do you call, let's say I have an employee called as procurement agent. So he will work under procurement, also he will work under inventory. So two different departments. So if I want to give track this particular person based on the department, I will say assignment number is 4106. So, so-and-so person is allocated for this department.
Oh, okay, okay. So, for inventory purpose, we use as 4106. In case of other assignment, we say some other code, for example, 4108. 4108.
Yes, correct.
Sir, location in Chennai, we have created Chennai in this space.
Which one?
Location, location.
Okay, okay. Yeah, that also we can give, not an issue.
pair of notes.
Okay, so that's about the basic information about employee creation, and these are like statutory information. If we want to capture, so we can capture all this information. Okay. Yeah. So yeah, so we'll see what are the information that we have. So we created one simple employee. So I'll just save and I'll explain from start. So I can capture n number of information under this single page called people maintenance. So firstly, I can capture the first name, last name, and the title and prefix or suffix if I have anything, and the middle name. So these are the information that I have only to capture the name of the particular employee. Okay. And apart from that, I can capture these information, that is the gender and whether this is an employee or this is an applicant. All those information can be captured. And once I save this particular employee record, I'll be able to see the employee number. So employee number here is 4106. Assignment number is different from employee number. So employee number is nothing but my own identity. So that is, let's say 4106 is a track for this person working under this organization called payroll business unit. So now I'm working under this one also, or you call the next unit also. So that will have different assignment number. Okay.
The employee number will be common. For example, if I rack this service, the employee number is a particular one, but his function varies. No, the assignment number is 4106 means he is working in a indent two. In case of other events, you have another assignment. How both will be same?
No, this is based on the sequence that we are defining. So we are using the standard sequence for both the cases. So that is why we will see same number defined for this as well. So if I want to add the second assignment, so I will have to create it again. But the assignment number there, if you see, that will be different.
But another employee number will be common only. Yes, a particular employee number.
Employee number assignment is common only. No, are you asking that we should have a separate sequence for employee and a separate sequence for assignment?
My question is, for example, while creating assignment, we have assignment number of 4106. Then okay. Which is function is in inventory only.
Okay.
This function in inventory is assignment 4106. In case of if in other. If he's also working equipment, his assignment number will be 4110.
Okay.
We are considering 4110. But the employee code here is 4106 only.
Correct. 4110.
The assignment value will be both values. 4106 and also 4110. But the employee code is there must be a unique employment code. That's the name.
So now, let's say if I create a new record here, but I need separate organization. We created only one. Okay, we will see this probably at a later point. We will create one more organization and we will see this part. Okay. Yeah, so we will see more details probably tomorrow. We will stop here. And we'll connect same time tomorrow, 8:30.
So in people, we knew the entire details we have created that up till now.
Sorry?
This is correct, sir. In people, if we can see the entire details we have created till now.
Yes, correct. We can see. Yes, correct.
From the birth date, address, picture. Okay, sir.
Correct.
Okay, sir.
Any doubt till now, or then we can close the call?
No. Sir, can I explain it from basics? Can you hear me? Same thing, correct?
Yeah, sir.
At the initial stage, but the inquiry stage, get the details from the customer in about what the organization we have to create. Then getting the details, then we go with the creating the business group. Then depending on the business group, then you go with the role position of the first. You have to understand the position. Then depending on the position, we have to move with the particular flexible means for a particular position. We are creating. We must create a flexible. For example, considering for today they have given us an accountant for flexible that's 01 accountant. And after creating the flexibility, we are the, giving him the further function of him. Then after the, then only we are creating the employee name and also giving him the assignment number.
Correct.
Till now, is it correct, sir? I'm saying correctly, sir.
Yes, correct. Correct.
Oh, okay, sir. Yeah. Sir, but I have one common doubt, sir.
But
in the inquiry stage itself, there is more clarification. You have to get a clearance from customer and
Clarity in the sense you are talking about requirement.
Query. If we have query at our end.
Okay.
Once at the inquiry stage, we have query. We ask the query from the and clearance. We must get clearance from the customer end. So we must wait for a certain time. Then it takes time, no, sir.
Yeah, it will take time definitely.
Only after the clearing the course, you can enter into a particular further job and course.
Yeah, yes, we should wait for it. I mean, we don't have options, so that that we will have to wait actually.
Okay.
Yeah. Anything else?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
No, sir. Just I now got a basic information. Now I am able.
Okay. Yeah, maybe if we don't have anything, we can wind up.
Yes, sir. Please, can you share today from starting till now, sir? This one.
Yeah, sure. I'll send you the document and also I'll send you this video. So the session is recorded, so I'll share this one also.
Yeah, sure, sir. And what about practice, sir?
Practice probably I'll check with Suresh and I'll ask him to share the instance details.
Maybe provide something, sir, because we also practice means it's better.
Yeah, understood. I'll ask him to share the details with you.
Sure, sir. If any doubts is there, we'll text you, sir.
Yeah, sure. You can ping me anytime. So I can.
So good name, please, sir.
Yeah, my name is Arun.
I am not that.
Arun.
So myself, Madhavan, sir.
Yeah, good. Good meeting you.
Myself, Ashna, sir.
Yeah, Ashna. Nice meeting you. Okay.
Okay.
We'll connect tomorrow, same time.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, thanks.
No.